This week, the superintendent's end-of-week message is coming from North Middle School. I'm going to head down to the media center to meet some new friends. Our end-of-week message this week is coming from North Middle School, and we have landed here at North Middle School on a very special day. I have Mrs. Johnson with us, principal of North Middle School, and she has brought along a special guest. So, Ms. Johnson, introduce our guest this morning and why it's such a fantastic day at North Middle School.
Well, this is Indiana Walker, and Indiana is a seventh grade student here at North Middle School. And today we had a fundraiser for our school, and it's actually to benefit her brother, who is currently battling cancer. He's a former cadet, part of our North Nation. Just because he's out of our building doesn't mean he's not still in our hearts. And so he is currently a 10th grader at Henderson County High School. And so we ended up having a free dress day today. So students could bring $2.
That is big.
Yes. They will do anything for a free dress day.
Sure.
But our students were allowed to bring in $2 today to make a donation, and they were allowed to have free dress today. And so we're pretty excited. Our current total is $1,825 in that we will be able to donate to Adarius to help with his family with his medical bills. So we're excited.
Fantastic. And tell us a little bit about the shirt that you have on it.
Well, like, my mom, like, she ordered this. Like, this is from one of his friends at the high school.
Sure.
And in the front, it says, fight cancer. And then on the back, it says,
Fantastic. So we will have to make sure that when we post our end-of-week message, that we put hashtag #EndoStrong in the back and link it right to that, or tag it as well. Is there anything you want us to know about your brother?
Well,
okay, so is he a sophomore?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, everybody's saying, like, he should be able to fight it because he's young.
Sure.
But, like, I don't understand how it happened, to be honest, because he played basketball at the high school.
Sure.
And he, like, worked out almost every day, so I don't understand how it happened.
Sometimes you can be physically very strong, even mentally very strong, and that those cancer cells, they just, they start to build and divide. So he's an athlete.
Mm-hmm.
So he is physically strong and mentally
strong.
He was
shocked about it too.
Oh, I'm sure. Absolutely. Well, I want to say I think this is it's a service learning project, obviously, but it's going to somebody that your kids, Ms. Johnson, know and have been here and appreciate.
It was amazing when they came in the door this morning, because not only were they bringing in $2, some of them wore their uniform and still put money in the bucket. Many of them brought in extra money. So if they brought in a 5 or a 10, they said just go ahead and keep all of it in there. We don't need any change.
Wonderful.
It was a really good day to see North Nation in action.
Ms. Johnson, I also heard that some students brought in extra money and gave it to friends, so that they could put in the bucket and then have a free dress day. Did that happen some?
Oh, yes, yes. And we had staff members also. If they, if some of them are very close to certain kids, and so the kids that they were afraid may not be able to have free dress day today, a lot of the staff
sponsored
also,
them, didn't they?
Yes.
Very nice.
It's a good day to be a cadet.
It is. It is always a great day at North Nation. But today's a little extra special day because the kindness and thoughtfulness of this family community at North Nation is really shining through. And don't forget, if you want to follow the progress, hashtag #EndoStrong. Thanks for taking time out of class. I heard the bell just ring, so I'm sure you're eager to get back. It's a pleasure to meet you. And thank you for your time, Ms. Johnson. I'd like to introduce to you from North Middle School a few new friends that I have just recently met. And they're going to talk to us a little bit about a program that they do here at North Middle School on a daily basis called Alveus. So Jefferson, nice to meet you. And what grade are you in?
I'm in eighth grade.
Eighth grade. And Caitlin, my pleasure to meet you. Mrs. Stanley, what grade are you in?
Eighth grade.
So we have two eighth grade North Nation students here. tell us a little bit about the curriculum that you all have started using this year called Alveus.
Well, every week we have like a new kind of subject and a new like role to follow.
Okay.
And pretty much our teacher will just like give us a little bit of information about it, and we'll tell our opinions, and we'll tell them how we think to help with the bullying and the situations, and just like personal experiences.
Sure. What rule are you most recently working on, Jefferson?
I don't really like doing English on all these things, like, because like, we have this little group around us.
Sure.
So, because we grab our chairs, we have a little circle, we talk to the teacher about, like, what happens in our situations, like, what should we do?
Sure.
Or, like, what, like, other people wouldn't do. Mm-hmm. So, how we should counter this.
Gotcha. So, it's not like a classroom setting where you're just sitting there and the teacher's giving you information. Kids kind of sit in circles and you talk to each other.
Yeah.
Tell me a couple topics that you all talked about in your classrooms.
Well, we've talked about like hot spots, which is like places in the school where a lot of bullying like occurs.
Mm-hmm.
And we've talked about how to like prevent all of that from happening, like in
sure.
the cafeteria, in the gym. When a teacher's
big spaces where lots of kids come together.
Yeah.
And teachers are there supervising, but they're not right near and can
yeah.
hear everything going on.
There's like too many kids and it's just harder for them.
Right.
So we have to kind of take action and like try to help.
Sure. What are some strategies you've learned of how to help?
So like when someone's alone, like, and when they're alone at the table at lunch or breakfast, we usually have to counter them and like say they want to be with us and like involve them and stuff. Because some kids always get excluded from stuff. So
right.
our teachers told us like, so we can come and talk to them and sit with them. If they don't want to join us, it's all right. So we can like keep on trying, so we can be friends with them.
But you're reaching out to them
yeah.
to let them know that they're welcome.
Mm-hmm.
And that's an emotional feeling that everybody wants, isn't
mm-hmm.
it? Sure. What do you feel as kids, students here at North Middle School, has been the best benefit by having these discussions?
This year I've realized I've had a lot more friends,
mm-hmm.
and
great.
That like just like girls in general, I feel like there's not really like mean girls anymore.
Mm-hmm.
They're all just kind of, we all get along a lot more now that we understand each other and understand how to cope with situations a lot better instead of just creating drama.
Right. What are your thoughts on that? What are some, I don't know, some things that you think have benefited you or the school?
So, like, this year it's been, like, okay. I mean, I met a lot more friends than last year.
Sure.
I've been more cooperative and I've been,
mm-hmm.
like, more out with, like, other people.
Because, mm-hmm.
Like, sometimes, like, I used to get, like, bullied when I was in school.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, because I moved here from New York, so... So everything had to change and
right.
stuff, so...
And we're very different than New York.
Yeah.
Right?
It was so different from right now, so
sure.
I had to change a lot.
Right. And have you felt like that's helped you understand our culture in ways as much as it was at your old school?
Yeah.
Good. Well, I'm thrilled that you're a North Nation student now. It's a pleasure to meet you, Jefferson and Caitlin. I hope you all have a fantastic day.
You too.
And thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mrs. Johnson, it's a pleasure to be here at North today. We're always happy to have you, Miss Stanley.
Wonderful.
And, you know, we're almost to spring break. Next week is spring break, and students won't be in the building. It'll be quiet. But what have you really focused on this first 9 weeks here at North Middle School, besides academics? We know academics is always number one. But what else have you really been focusing on?
Building character. Like, we want our students not only to come out of our building, we want them to exit North Nation not only with a strong academic foundation, but we also want them to be strong in their character. We want them to know who they are, what they stand for, how to interact with other people, and how to be a positive influence on society.
In the library, we were there a little earlier, and they talked to us about a new curriculum. Which curriculum means different lessons, a program that all of your teachers have been trained in and are teaching on a regular basis here called Alveus.
Yes, we are an Alveus school, and we went through training last summer. We have We have a steering committee for our Alveus that helps us design our lessons. We constantly look at our data. Mm-hmm. And essentially what we do is we design what lessons the kids are going to do. Sure. They are all around just how to be better people. Such as about 2 weeks ago, our Alveus lesson was about problem solving, where kids would look at different, we actually started with cartoons.
Sure.
So they would look at a cartoon that was some sort of bullying, and they had to identify what kind of bullying it was, and then they had to problem solve in a small group as to how they could handle that situation, how to fix it, how to work through it, or what they needed to do, and so they worked in groups. So last week's lesson, students were talking about different hot spots in our building.
Sure.
Like what areas do they see bullying occurring? How can they handle it? And they essentially, they gather their chairs up in a little small group and they have very intimate discussions about what's going on. So Alveus is more or less about building relationships. It's about our teachers getting close to our kids, knowing lots and lots about them, but it's also about kids being able to share things that maybe they wouldn't share in another
sure.
setting,
sure.
and so that other kids get to start to see things from perspectives other than their own,
right.
which is sometimes hard.
And the kids talked about that. The kids, we talked in the library, talked about how we're not in rows in the classroom. We get in a circle and we talk to each other through these issues, and what a better way to teach is through scenarios and real life experiences that the kids deal with every day. I know that you all have definitely seen great progress by using these lessons, and I don't know if you remember, but last fall we were here at North visiting, and this Kentucky map was empty. And you guys can now see it's full of handprints, and these are all handprints of students who said that they were going to stamp out the bullying. They wanted to get involved and stop the bullying. And it's very impressive and a reminder as the kids walk by the map every day of what character is. And what's even better is that they can talk about it through their eyes. Not through our eyes as adults, but through their eyes. You know, Ms. Johnson, it's always a great day at North Middle School, and we have thoroughly enjoyed our time here, and thanks for taking time out of your busy schedule to say hello to us.
Well, we appreciate you coming over.
We
love opportunities to show what kinds of things we have going on here at North Nation and how we're working to make our kids the best that they can be.
Absolutely. We appreciate that. And don't forget, next week is spring break. Kids, you can sleep in every day if you would like to. You all have a wonderful weekend and enjoy your time off from school.